Hello everyone, again, we are here in the local market of the Concordia. We are here with María. Hello María.
Hola.
¿Cómo estás María? ¿Cómo
está
todo el mundo?
Bien.
So today we have a special, we have two special recipes for you. So with María, here in the recipes of the Great Mother, Recetas de la Abuela restaurant, we will show you how to do some really traditional Colombian breakfast. It's actually from Colombia and Venezuela, and the name is huevos pericos, so pericos eggs. This is a funny thing because this is a perico is a word in Colombia. They have the same origin, you know, but then they have different meanings. We will speak about that later, but right now we will start with María to do some huevos pericos. This is kind of a scrambled eggs. So we have the ingredients. They are
huevos pericos. Aquí viene. Yo quiero huevos pericos. Huevos pericos viene. Tomate.
So you have some tomato. She has a special tomato. She used today cherry tomatoes. It's a really simple kind of recipe. And then we have here.
Y vamos con la cebolla. Normalmente utilizamos los rabitos de la cebolla, que es más sabroso los huevos pericos.
So we have this kind of onion here. There is the long onion. And some places they call it green onion.
O pueden utilizar cebolla, la puerro, la parte verdecita, o la cebolla.
So you can cebollín, so you cebollín. Can use the another kind of cebollas, onion, you know, there is the same family of this one. We have the long onion, the green one, and then we have the puerro, and then we have cebollín in the Caribbean coast of Colombia. She have a little bit more of oil.
Dejamos que se sofría un poquito.
So you leave it.
Vamos a adicionarle otro poquito de aceite. Dejamos que se sofría.
So the quantity that she's cooking right now is for two people. María, ¿y no le colocas sal a esto?
Espera.
Vamos. Okay.
Pues ya tenemos los huevos acá, vamos a batirlos. Entonces acá le adicionamos salecita.
So, before you scramble the eggs, you put the
si quieren un poquito de
salt. It depends of you if you want to put a different kind of species.
Sí.
But traditional ingredients are tomato, onion, and the eggs. That is huevos pericos. So, as I told you before, pericos have different meanings in Colombia. So that is why later we want to go to the coffee of the markets, and then we want to do another kind of pericos. There is it's a coffee, but these ones are eggs. So
aquí conseguimos el cafecito, el pintadito. En Bogotá acá tú pides un perico y tienes que especificar bien. Huevos pericos o un perico que es mitad leche y mitad tinto.
Okay, so that is a very funny thing because even in the explanation of María, that was a mixture of words because she said, okay, so pericos can be the scrambled eggs, you know, and then also a coffee, there is a black coffee with a little bit of milk. Yeah, but then she said tinto. Tinto is another kind of way to say coffee from Colombia. They use a black coffee. The origin of the word pericos is actually about the colors. You see, the colors of the eggs here is a mixture of green, red, and yellow. Yellow, you know, yellow because the eggs. So what happened here is that we have, in Colombia, we have a kind of pirate. The name of the pirate is perico, of course, in Spanish, pirate. And this special family of the pirate, this special bird, the name, the colloquial, the, you know, the street name is perico cara sucia. Uh-huh. So like a dirty face pirate, dirty face pirate. And this bird, this dirty face pirate, have special colors different to the other pirates, have some green like the onion, have some kind of red changing, and then in the peak, in the face, they have yellow as the eggs. That is why we call it the eggs like the pirates. But also they have brown and the checks of the on the of the of the pirate, they have some brown color like the coffee. So there is where come from the name Perico, from the special pirate that we have here, the Perico cara sucia. That was not really easy to find the meaning of Perico, where they come from, you know, like, but finally we find it from the special bird. You know, Colombia is a country with more variety of birds in the world. And we use the names of the birds from different things, from food in this case. María, ¿cuánto tiempo más o menos demoras cocinando los huevos?
Yo creo que llevamos unos 2 minuticos y con mucho tres, ponemos en bajito volumen para que no se nos queme y se cocine todo bien rico con las verduras, porque son los fritos con verduras.
So around 2 to 3 minutes, something really special. Sí. From the pericos, the eggs is different to a normal scrambled eggs, because in Colombia we have huevos revueltos también, but the difference between huevos revueltos and pericos is the huevos revueltos, they use it normally the rest of the food, you know, the what you don't use when you are cooking.
Huevos revueltos es simplemente revolver huevos estrellados. Entonces coge los huevos en la misma cacerola y los estrellas un tricito así para que queden blanquito y amarillo.
Ah, mira María, pero había otra cosa que yo le estaba comentando a la gente también, es que hay unos huevos que también se le echan, como que se le llaman revueltos, por ejemplo, y le echan verduras, pero son verduras que son las sobras, lo que utilizan de la comida, si le queda un poquito de tomate o no sé qué cosa. Algo bien especial que tiene el huevo perico es que se utiliza las verduras de origen. O sea, tú estás utilizando la cebolla y la picas, el tomate y lo picas, y sí, todo nuevo, todo directo para directo. Especial para esos huevos. Y eso hace que tenga un sabor único, un sabor que solamente lo reconoce la gente de estas tierras, ¿no? Algo bien original. Un huevo perico sabe a huevo perico y no a huevo revuelto, no, y no a otra cosa, ¿no?
Hay otra forma en que preparan los huevos, que por decir en la casa, que es coger huevos revueltos, que cogen el arroz, los huevos, los baten y le colocan arroz. Ajá. Y se hace la misma cocción, que por ejemplo el arroz del día anterior o que se preparan en el momento. Se prepara, dice, yo quiero huevos con arroz, y se revuelven y se mezcla todo y se saca y se le agrega cebolla y tomate.
Es diferente. So this is different ways to do scrambled eggs in Colombia, but the special thing about the Perico's eggs is that we don't use the rest of the food that I know, like when you're cooking some soup and then the rest of the tomato, you don't use it in the Perico's. In the Perico's, you use the original tomato and the original onion, and then you put it directly. It's prepared for the eggs, you know, especially for this kind of eggs.
Porque pues huevos se pueden hacer de muchas formas. El omelette de huevos que ya quiere combinado con carnes, con verduras diferentes, especies diferentes,
champiñones.
Entonces,
so look at this delicious thing
que
here.
Les gusta así. Hay otras personas que les gusta más sequito.
Eso tiene un
eso ya depende del gusto de la persona, como quiera comerlos. Esos están apenas, no están crudos, sino están apenas. Pero hay personas que les gusta más sequitos. Si quiere, pues lo podemos dejar más secos, pero así son riquísimos. Se puede acompañar con un trozo de pan.
So we have here the bread from the special artisanal bread from the Hamelin artisanal bread from Bogota. So it's also a very good breakfast. So we have here the Perico's eggs ready for to eat. Vamos a Andalorena, vamos allá.
Pasamos al mercado y allá van a hacer la diferencia del café, que también se llama Perico aquí en Colombia. Entonces,
so for the people that is just joining right now, so we have here the Perico's eggs, you know, this special kind of eggs that we do in Colombia. It's kind of like a scrambled eggs. And what is the difference with the other eggs? Well, it's about the colors, because we are using the green onion, the long green onion, and then we have two eggs that give the yellow color and the red from the tomato. So these colors looks like a parrot, a special parrot that is from Colombia, that the name is Perico Cara Sucia. So that bird, they have several colors in their body, and that is why the people from the many, many colony years, they start to use the name for the eggs, for the color of the eggs that looks like the pirate's color, pirate color. But also, we are here with Lorena. So Lorena is very busy because she's doing some cake to take away. She's the barista, one of the baristas from the farmer's coffee place in the market. So with Lorena, Café del Mercado, from Café del Mercado, we will do the second recipe of today. So what is the second recipe? We have the Perico's egg, and then we will do Perico coffee, you know? And Lorena will help us to know what is a Perico coffee. So also with Maria. María, we'll see you later.
Bueno, para que vean la diferencia y cuando vengan aquí a Bogotá, pues no se les haga nada extraño que hay unos huevos pericos y un perico que es un café también tradicional de acá.
Muchas gracias.
Y también los invitamos a que todos cuando lleguen aquí a Colombia o vengan a Bogotá, visiten la Plaza de Mercado La Concordia.
Ah, see, so today is the last day for us to broadcast directly here from the market. They is relocated here since they finished the rebuilding of the market, but the next broadcasting will be inside the original Concordia market when they get ready. So Lorena, tú me dirás cómo estás. Permisito por acá. So Lorena, she also has here different kind of coffees, methods. She has the roasted machine here. So she bring the coffee directly from the farms, and then they ground it and toast it here in the place. No sé si quieres contarnos más, yo te voy traduciendo.
Nosotros trabajamos directamente con los caficultores para poderle pagar un precio justo, evitamos los intermediarios y somos tostadores de café acá, somos la única tienda de especialidad que está ubicada en una plaza de mercado.
So they are the unique special coffee shop. They are located in a local market of Bogotá. You know, many of the special coffee shops, they are, because in Colombia we have coffee from origin, different kind of coffees, and special baristas, people in different, they are looking for to do the best coffee in Colombia. But the coffee from Lorena is even more special because she's located in a traditional Colombian market. So supporting the local market, the local farmers, and also improving and teaching to us, to Colombian people, how to drink a really good quality of Colombian coffee.
Listo, vamos a hacer dos tipos de perico. Hay dos maneras de prepararlo, y pues vamos a hacerlo. Listo, vamos a utilizarnos acá.
So here she's grounded the coffee. She's saying that we will do two kind of pericos. Two different ways to do a coffee perico. So for the people that is just joining, remember that today we are in the local market and we was cooking before. The video will be safe in the Instagram TV, so you can look how they do this special scrambled eggs that the name is huevos pericos as a parrot, the bird. And then we have here the coffee perico with Lorena. Bueno. So why is the difference between a black coffee, un café negro, y un perico? Por okay. Eso.
Pues es que eso cambia, mira. Por ejemplo, hay gente que le dice perico a un tinto, que es agua más café con un poco de leche.
So some people say perico to water, coffee, like a long coffee, long black coffee, and then milk. They call it perico. So, but always with milk. ¿Y qué más?
Y hay otra especie de perico que es un espresso con leche, que también se le llama café con leche. Pero yo considero que eso va a depender de la zona donde estés. Yo viví muchos años en el sur de Bogotá y la gente está acostumbrada a decirle perico.
Pero si tú vas de Chapinero hacia el norte, le llaman café con leche.
Okay, so this is interesting here. She said that we have two kinds of perico. So it's always coffee with milk, with a little bit of milk. But then someone is espresso with milk, you know. Someone is espresso with milk, as Lorena say. And the other one is a coffee, a long coffee, a long black coffee with milk. So depends of the location where you are, depends of the location where you are in Bogota, you will have, the people call it perico or coffee with milk, you know. But then we have two kind of ways for to do it: the long coffee with milk and the espresso with milk. So we have the espresso here.
Este sería el perico.
This is perico, but this one.
Un tinto con un poco de leche.
Lorena, pero este es como el más tradicional que encuentra uno en la calle, ¿no?
Sí, total. Este es el más tradicional.
Okay, so this is a perico. It was just a little bit of milk, and then we have here.
¿Es un café con leche?
This is a coffee with milk, but we also call it perico. It's a little bit more kind of like barista style, yeah? And then she have the...
Bueno, mi pelate no es tan chévere, ¿no?
Art here, yeah?
Y la diferencia es que, por ejemplo, sabemos que el perico puede ser de las dos maneras. Puede ser más intenso en café o más lechoso. Pero el café con leche, si el nombre lo dice, es mucho más lechoso.
Okay, so the perico, it has something special. It's more coffee than milk normally, yeah? But for example, coffee with milk, there also some people will say perico to this one, but it's coffee with milk, café con leche. This one is more milk than coffee, yeah? And then she can do this kind of art. Okay, Lorena, so si quieres invitar a la gente para cuando estén aquí.
Con gusto, bueno, aquí, cuando quieran venir, bienvenidos. Aquí lo manejamos mi esposo y yo. Nosotros somos campeones en un método de preparación que se llama Aeropress.
Okay.
Este es un método que salió en el 2016. Sebastián, mi esposo, fue el primer campeón aquí en Colombia.
So they are champion of this kind of method to do coffee, Aeropress, here in Colombia. First place, her husband was the champion of this in the 2016.
Y este es el mío, que yo viví en Francia.
So she lived in Paris, in France.
Y fui campeona regional 2017.
So 2017 she was the champion of barista of the Aeropress in Paris, in France. Wow.
Entonces, aquí, bienvenidos. Les preparamos los mejores cafés, además que está atendido por sus dueños.
Okay, so Lorena, she said that it's welcome when you are here in Colombia. You can visit here, the local market. You can join one of our tours, and then after that, you can just go directly to try one of the best coffees from Colombia. So right now,
el mejor café colombiano.
The best coffee from Colombia. So right now, before we go, I want to let you know that we start this video broadcasting from the restaurant Recetas de la Abuela, and we was doing some pericos eggs. And now we have some perico coffee. So in Colombia we have this kind of polysemic word. It's a word that coming from the same origin, and the origin is a bird. The name is perico cara sucia. They have different kind of colors. In the breast of the bird, they have the color of the coffee, and in the rest of the body of the bird, they have different colors, green and yellow, as the egg. So that is why we call it pericos. Both of the coffee and also the eggs, the name is perico. So thank you so much for joining today. I have to do this. This is the last day of quarantine. Hopefully we are back to do tours soon, and you are welcome to come to Colombia, to Bogota, and join Lorena here in the coffee of the market. And Maria. Maria.
Maria.
Hola.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Esta.
I see you later.